Number 9, we have
Darkwing Duck.
When you're hungry, Snickers satisfies.
Lights, camera, 3, 2, 1, action!
Welcome
to
MMS
News.
Now,
roll
the intro!
Welcome, MMS, and good welcome to you, Ava.
And good welcome to you too, Nick.
And here we are, back with another wonderful break with your favorite 16th little leading middle school news program, MMS News. And let's see what character trait we are focusing on this month.
Remember, we continue to focus on the character traits even though we should still be 6 feet away from each other and some could be under a mask. This month's character trait is caring.
Caring means to display kindness and concern for others. If you see someone being caring here at MMS, go to the MMS News website and fill out the survey to see your name scroll across the screen.
We can't wait to see what kind of caring students we have here at MMS.
Our first story is ready to give you everything you need to know about all the wonderful ways you can show your MMS pride and support your favorite Trojan. Hello, MMS. Welcome back to the week ahead. Monday, there's 6th grade dance, homework club, MMS news, builders club, wrestling at Creekside, and a girls basketball game versus Creekside. Good luck to all of our athletes. Tuesday, there's 6th grade dance, homework club, yearbook club, chess, reading, winter running club, drama, and intramural girls basketball. Wednesday, there's free guitars for future stars, superfans at a game, girls basketball at Parkland, and a wrestling meet versus Parkland. Go Trojans! Thursday is the MMS Spelling Bee, homework club, drama, winter running club, and intramural girls basketball. Friday, there's 6th grade dance. Saturday, there's solo and ensemble. Have a great weekend, MMS, and remember to stay involved.
We are keeping things seriously fashionable here at MMS, so put on your finest as we shine a true spotlight on one of our greatest divas from MMS's past.
Hello, MMS. We are still continuing our 10th anniversary, which is the same script, so we are going to interview an old MMS newscaster.
Welcome back to MMS News. So can you tell us what your name is and what you did on MMS News?
Hi. My name is Stacy Carrera, and when I was in MMS News, I was part of a segment called the Fashionista Divas.
Hey, MMS.
We are the
Fashionista Divas.
And today is Friday the 13th. Just thought I'd say that.
What seasons were you part of MMS News?
I was part of seasons 1 through 3.
What was your favorite story on MMS News?
It was so long ago, I can't tell you a specific story that I did that's my favorite, but I can tell you that they were all extremely fun to write and film.
What did you learn from doing MMS News?
I learned that I am very loud and I very much like being in front of a camera, and it actually inspired me to want to be a writer and possibly go into film.
Any advice for students that are doing MMS News?
I guess the only advice that I can give you is to make sure that you speak loudly, you speak clearly, and you know what you're saying. I know a lot of times that it's easy to just write what you're doing and then just go out there and do it without practicing, but if you don't care what you're saying, about what you're saying, the people listening to you aren't going to care either. So just make sure that it's something that you're passionate about or something that you know really well about, or else everyone else is going to be in the same boat that you are.
That's it for this week. See you next time with another person under the spotlight.
Isn't this? Look at this. Okay, I found this at the Goodwill in Broadway in the Halloween section.
Whoa,
this isn't Halloween. This is just tacky, people. This isn't Halloween. This is tacky. There's a difference. I know. Go ahead, laugh.
Get the final word in this week's Word on the Street. Word up.
Today's question on Word on the Street is, what would you do with your first snow day?
On a snow day, I would play outside in the snow with my kids and then make hot cocoa with marshmallows.
Well, the first thing I would do on a snow day would be to go back to sleep.
I'd get up and exercise and then go shovel all that snow.
I'd probably watch a movie.
Sleep in.
Snacks.
I would check the weather and see if it's actually a snow day first. If I know it's a snow day, I would text my friend and see if he wants to come and make snow forts and have a snowball fight or play video games.
Snowball fight.
Yeah, probably snowball fight.
I would do snowball fight too.
Just sledding.
Snowball fight.
I would stay in my room.
Go sledding.
This is Wyatt with Word on the Street. We'll see you next time.
The MMS book reviewer keeps reading everything and anything to ensure that you only check out the best stories. So let's see what she is reading this week.
Hello, MMS, and welcome back to MMS News. This week I will be reviewing The Blackbird Girls by Anne Blackman. One morning, two girls wake up to a bright red sky. They have a problem in the nuclear power plant in Chernobyl. Before long, the two enemies are on their way towards one girl's grandmother. One girl is Jew and the other is not. Will this problem bring them closer together? All the while, another story about a Jew on the run and all alone. A surprising connection brings the two stories together. With a 4.44 star review on Goodreads, I give it 5 stars. This is a Rebecca Caudle nominee. If you want to participate, you have to read 3 books and turn in the form by February 16th. If you have any recommendations, email me at tcarpent899@d15.org. Have a great day and weekend, MMS. Have fun and keep reading.
The comic updaters went out and bought all the new issues, read them through, and want to show some pretty pictures in this week's comic review.
Hello, MMS! We are changing it up this week by giving you 10 new comics coming out this month that you should pick up.
Our number 1, Detective Comics, number 1068.
Number 2, we have Amazing Spider-Man, number 18.
Number 3, we have the Amazing Action Comics, number 1051.
Number 4, we have Star Wars Yoda, number 3.
Number 5, we have Justice Society of America, number 2.
Number 6, we have Batman Gotham Knights Gilded City, number 4.
Number 7, we have All Out Adventures, number 5.
Number 8, we have Mighty Morphin Power Rangers and TMNT, number 2.
Number 9, we have Darkwing Duck, number 1.
Number 10, we have Tim Drake Robin, number 5.
For one I might recommend is buying is Darkwing Duck.
The one that I recommend buying this month is Mighty Morphin Power Rangers and TMNT, number 2.
That's all, MS. See you next week with more comics and characters.
Want a reason to eat all the popcorn and buy all the snacks? Then grab a seat and pick a movie. Time to check out this week's movie review.
Movie of the week is Superman and Batman, Battle of the Sun, the Super Sun. It is available on HBO Max streaming.
It is the first CGI animated film from DC Entertainment.
John Kent and Damon Lindsay must team up again against their father to finally stop again a villain.
With a huge cast that includes Green Arrow, Lex Luthor, Lois Lane, Batman, Superman, Robin, and Superboy, and many more, you can expect there to be a ton of great action and even more superheroes saving the day.
We give it a 4.5 star review.
Predictable, but fun.
If the music is loud, it can only mean one thing. We are ready to rock and roll with this week's Top 10.
Good morning, everyone.
Welcome to Top 10, one of the best topics on MMS News. Now let's get dancing.
Our number 10 song is Lose Control by Medusa, Becky Hill, and the Good Boys.
Need to know, could you be the one to call when I lose control?
Our number 9 is Under the Boardwalk by the Drifters.
Where I'll be.
Under the boardwalk.
Out of the sun.
Under the boardwalk.
Our number 8 song is Earthland by B.O.B.
I wish right now, can we pretend that airplanes in the night sky like shooting stars? I can really use a wish right now.
Our number 7 song is Kill Bill by S.Z.A.
Now you lay your face down, got me singing over a beat.
I'm so mature, I'm so mature, I'm so mature,
and let me get
therapy to tell
my desire. Our number 6 is Firework by Katy Perry.
July, 'cause baby you're a firework. Come on, show 'em what you're worth. Make 'em go
Halfway through this list is our number 5 song, Made You Look by Meghan Trainor.
I go in my Louis Vuitton, but even with nothing on, but I made you look.
Our number 4 song is Golden Hour by
Jibbutt.
Our number three song is Boyfriend by Selena Gomez.
But I want love again and again. I want a boyfriend. I've been up all night, pretty restlessly.
Our number two song is Space Girls by Frances Forever.
Guess what our number one song is? Flowers by Miley Cyrus. This has been awesome. I hope you all have a great rest of your day.
Stay safe and stay out of trouble. Don't forget to keep listening to music. Bye, MMS!
The Retro Gamer has another super classic all-star level game to challenge you all weekend long. If you can find it, that is.
Hello, MMS. Today we'll be reviewing Kirby Squeak Squad.
Kirby Squeak Squad was released in 2006 for the Nintendo DS.
Kirby Squeak Squad follows Kirby and his quest to retrieve his strawberry shortcake from a gang of mice called the Squeak Squad.
Kirby assumes it was King Dedede's fault and tracks him down.
After finding out that King Dedede didn't steal the cake, he then finds out the Squeak Squad stole his cake.
Kirby Squeak Squad was the second game released on the DS and the first mainline Kirby game on the DS.
New abilities come into play like the animal ability and many more.
That's all for this week, MMS, and have a good rest of the week.
The playoffs are underway, and the road to finding out who is the best is picking up steam. So let's throw it to our sports center to see who's playing this week.
Hello, MMS, and welcome back.
In the NFL, it is going to be the Chiefs and the Bengals in the AFC Championship game fighting for a spot in the Super Bowl. In the NFC, it is the Eagles playing the 49ers.
In the NHL, the Blackhawks lost to the Kings 2-1.
In the NBA, the Bulls beat the Pistons in the Paris game 126-108.
NCAA football, Georgia dominated in the championship game over TCU with a 65-7 win.
In NCAA basketball, Illinois lost to Indiana 80-65. They will play in Madison against Wisconsin tomorrow. In other news, number 2 Kansas lost 2 games last week, and number 1 Houston lost to Temple 56-55. The number 3 Purdue survived the scare against Michigan State, embarrassed Minnesota, and survived against Maryland.
The Puppy Bowl voting is now available, so vote for it.
That's all for this week.
We spent all break house training our next story, so there shouldn't be any accidents with this week's Animal Jam.
Welcome back to Amazing Animals.
This is Leah.
And this is Kelsey.
Today we will be talking about the pancake tortoise.
The pancake tortoise is a shelled reptile native to Tanzania and Kenya, known for its thin and flexible shell.
The animal is critically endangered and can only be found in specific hillsides and arid deserts.
And they can live up to more than 30 years.
30 years may sound old, but most tortoises live over 100 years.
They are also social animals living in small colonies of 5 to 10. Finally, their diet mainly consists of dry grasses and succulents.
That's all for Amazing Animals. Have a good day.
This random interruption is randomly going to give you all the randomly selected random bits of random fun and the randomest random facts ever be randomly selected. How random. Hello, MS. Today we have 3 more incredibly random and amazing fun facts.
Let's get right into it.
Did you know that the brand name Spam is actually a combination of the words spice and ham?
That's so cool. Hey, Ava, a cow-bison hybrid is called a beefalo. Isn't that weird?
What a funny name for an animal.
Our last fact is that Dolly Parton once entered a Dolly Parton lookalike contest and lost to a drag queen.
I never knew that. Bye, MMS, and have a great weekend.
Which would you rather, have a time machine or watch our next story? Well, we know which one you're picking.
Today's would you rather question is, would you rather live in a mansion or alone, or
live in a crowded apartment with lively strangers?
I would rather live in a mansion alone.
I would choose to live in a mansion by myself, because even though I might be a little bit lonely, I could read all the books I want without any interruptions.
I'd rather live in a mansion alone.
I'd rather live in a mansion alone.
I would choose a mansion because an apartment that's crowded with strangers, I think, would set off my anxiety.
I'd rather live in a mansion alone because I'll have my own space.
I would rather live in a mansion alone.
I would rather live in a mansion alone.
I'd rather live in a mansion alone.
I would rather live in a mansion alone because I can listen to Taylor Swift as loud as I want and I don't have to share my snacks with anybody.
It was really close between the mansion and the apartment, but
the score was 10-0.
Mansion won.
The JFL are back with some more gut-busting, side-splitting, eye-crying funny that is the best for any Friday.
Hello, Trojans! Welcome back to the funniest videos you'll ever see. At number one, we have Falling in Style.
At number two, we have Never Let Them Know Your Next Move.
Lastly, we have the best singing ever.
And that's all for this week, MMS. And don't forget to keep laughing.
Have a great weekend and be safe, MMS. And remember to stay classy from at least 6 feet away. And wash your hands, please.
Here's a visual showing what carbon dioxide levels look like in the atmosphere. The amazing thing about this is that you can actually see how the Amazon rainforest breathes in and eliminates the carbon dioxide. This is how the Canadian military wakes up anyone caught sleeping on the job. This diver knows how to defend himself from slow-motion turtle attacks. This bird sounds exactly like R2-D2 from Star Wars.
Who's my precious?
So this is pretty cool. There's a type of sea urchin that glows a bright orange color. This dog found a great place to use the bathroom. That is the end of this video. I really hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys again very, very soon. Later.
OMG.